And welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. We're going to be treated to a gorgeous day for baseball on the show. It's the Chicago Cubs and the Milwaukee Brewers. And we'll be back for the first pitch right after this. Just about ready to go and towing the slab in this one, Corbin Burns.
Well, he comes at hitters with a five-pitch mix, so for him, it's always interesting to see how he utilizes those weapons. He may lean on one or two pitches depending on how things are going and how things are working, but if he can control four or even five of those offerings, look out, hitters. It's going to be a tough day. He's really going to be able to keep those guys off balance.
All right, ready to get underway. Rafael Ortega stands in. Here comes a pitch. And first offering is fouled off.
First pitch, 1 o'clock.
The pitch. Strike two.
Got away with that one. Left the curveball up a little bit. He's going to have to finish it if it's going to be an effective pitch.
And here it comes. Pop. Wong. Has this one sized up? He's got it. One down. Here's a look at the Cubs lineup. A tough challenge in this one. An excellent arm on the mound. Singy, they're going to have to capitalize on their opportunities.
Yeah, and they're not going to get a whole lot if he pitches the way that he's capable of pitching. So, you know, be ready to swing from the first pitch. You get something straight, man, you better turn on it.
So digging in, Frank Schwindel. Pitch misses inside. Ball one. Nice warm day here. Good baseball weather. Does that change anything, Chris, especially for the hitters?
Absolutely. You feel so much more comfortable at the plate. You're not worried about, you know, getting jammed on fastballs inside part of the plate. You can kind of be more selective instead of just looking out away so that you can get the barrel to it in that part. You can get on the inside part of the plate as well.
Now a step off the rubber to reset. The 1-1. Swing and a miss. Swing and a miss, and he got him. That's out number two. Wilson Contreras now up to the plate. This guy has turned into one of the best catchers in the game, but was originally signed by the Cubs as an infielder. No score, just getting started, top of the first. Next offering is in for a strike. Kicks and deals. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Cubs 0. Brewers coming up to hit. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Bottom of the first. And today's starter, Marcus Stroman. What do we need to know here?
Anytime you have five pitches to work with on the mound, that repertoire can be a real weapon in terms of keeping hitters off balance, man. It's one of those things that I'm going to be looking for in this one. Does he have a feel for all of those pitches, or is he just able to get one or two over in the strike zone where he wants? It's tough to do to be able to command all those pitches, but if he can, he is going to be very tough for the opponent today.
That one ripped right center field. It's gone! He made him pay for that one, and they jump out front. It's 1-0. He only needed one swing to square it up.
Not wasting any time in that at bat, Boog. Aggressive, and it paid off. When you're working with this kind of velocity, it's so critical that you move the ball around, work quickly, and make sure that you keep that hitter off balance. Clearly not fooled by the location or the velocity. He was all over that fastball.
Willy Adames stands in.
Batting second. Not shortstop.
And first offering is fouled off.
Okay, from here, he's got to treat this as a clean inning. Forget about the fact that his team is now down by a run.
Yoan. Well struck left field. This one's got a chance. And that one is out of here. An absolute blast to left. And they add to the lead. It's 2-0.
Back-to-back jacks, and this club is fired up right now, Boone. This is the kind of thing where you really start to notice hitters in a lineup feeding off each other, and the collective confidence just continues to grow.
And now it's Christian Yelich.
Batting third, the left fielder, Christian.
Ripped on a line.
Yelich.
Hat puts the squeeze on that one, and there's one down.
Batting.
Let's take a look at the Brewers lineup. All right, Singy, how about all the talent in this lineup?
They're deep, first and foremost, but the way that they can manipulate their personnel for matchups and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team, and I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially in a big game, big series.
And now it's Andrew McCutchen. Check swing, but he went too far, and that's strike one. Stroman. He's the kind of starter that a lot of pitching coaches and managers as well really appreciate. Not a guy who's going to get himself into trouble by dancing around, by walking guys. One down, base is empty. Check swing, but he went too far. 0-2 now.
Yeah, he throws strikes, and you know he's got the command, be in the zone, be effective, but just moving the ball around, getting the ball back from the catcher, Boog, and throwing the pitch.
Oh, now this is blasted. Way back there, on its way, gone. Andrew McCutchen blasts one out, and they tack one on the board. It's 3-0. He absolutely crushed that one.
No doubt about that one, Boog. We knew it wasn't coming back.
Chris, that ball came out hot. So let's see what StatCast has to say.
Yeah, it really did, Boog. 111 miles per hour off the bat, and a really nice launch angle as well. Just a beautiful swing from start to finish.
And now it's Rowdy Tellez.
Batting fifth, the first baseman, Rowdy.
To the right side, Madrigal handles. Whips it to first. Fine play in the hole for the out. It's an interesting thing when you consider limiting walks. Is it more important today because of how many home runs are being hit?
No doubt. Keeping guys off the base paths with the way the swings and the launch angles are today, the emphasis of hitting home runs is so huge. It's never been more important.
And first offering is fouled off. The wind of the pitch. There's a swing and a drive. And that one's gone. Hunter Renfro hits one out. And they add to their lead. It's 4-0. That's their fourth home run of the game.
They can't stop, and they won't stop hitting home runs in this one, Boo. They're clearly feeding off of each other at the dip. Anytime you have a pitch down the middle of the plate, the percentages go up for the hitter to do damage, even if it's a pretty good sinker like that one. Nice piece of hitting there at the plate.
Omar Narvaez at the plate. Swing and a base hit.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
Now it's Lorenzo Cain. Yeah, I think the other part, though, as well, is it goes both ways, because I think the guys at times are more than willing to give up walks because they'll come back and strike the next guy out. Next offering is fouled back. Narvaez, the runner at first with two gone. Got it. That is the inning. We move to the second in Milwaukee. It's the Brewers 4 and the Cubs nothing. 1-1-2-1-2. That was the zip code. December 27 was the birth of Kanata, the Met fan born in the home. Top of the second. Digging in is the switch inning outfielder, Ian Happ. The Cubs in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. Need a good at bat out of him right here.
And he deals. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
He's already pitching with a 4-0 lead, so we should see him be aggressive. Fill up the strike zone. Don't issue free passes.
Next offering is in for a strike. Joe McDonald, our umpire behind the dish.
Yeah, Boog, Joey Mack. Sometimes a little tough to figure out. We may see some hitters and pitchers asking him where a pitch was here or there, but most of the time he keeps it reasonable.
Left-hand batter waits. Swing and a miss. One ball, two and the count, down. 1-2. At the belt and fires. And down on strikes he goes, and that's the first out.
Came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, a little anxious.
Patrick Wisdom.
Patrick Wisdom will hit next. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Burns. He's one of those guys who uses the cut fastball as his primary offering, and when it's on, it can induce a lot of weak contact. And he'll 1. Ball one there.
And the late movement on the cutter is really what makes it so effective, because as a hitter, you make a decision whether you're going to swing or take a pitch before it actually gets into the zone. So that late movement causes it to miss the barrel of the bat, sometimes miss the bat entirely.
Swing and a ball lifted in the air, left field, pretty well struck. Bounces off the wall as he makes the grab.
Batting six, the designated hitter, Clint Frazier.
Clint Frazier now at the plate. Yeah, they talk about cutters as being lane changers because it's more of that side-to-side movement and very little of the downward tilt. In there for strike one.
Man, that pitch was dotted. So much talent on display when this guy's out there on the hill.
And he'll 1. They say it went. The punch out there, down on strikes, and he knew it. Nothing happening there for the Cubs. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. And welcome back. Now the third baseman, Jace Peterson.
Leading off for the Brewers, the third baseman, Jace Peterson.
The right-hander back to work. That one pulled foul. Singy wasn't very sharp in the first, got hit around a little bit, just wasn't able to locate particularly well. A lot of stuff at the fat part of the plate.
Yeah, Boog, he wasn't fooling anyone. It's a tough place to be because it's not always obvious what adjustments need to be made. Sometimes it's location, sometimes it's being too predictable. Sometimes you're tipping your pitches. He's going to need to figure it out quickly, though.
The 0-2. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Oh, and two now. And down on strikes. One gone here. Colton Wong up to him. This is a guy you got to keep an eye on when he digs in. Definitely been known to drop a drag bunt from time to time. And he's pretty good at it, Chris.
Yeah, and he creates a sense of urgency for the defense because of the speed, because of the ability to put down that bunt.
And now the 0-1. That one is absolutely belted. That's back there. And he dropped it.
You might be wondering, how did he only get a single out of that drive? Well, that was a masterful defensive play out there in center. He couldn't make the catch, but he played it perfectly in terms of getting the ball back into the infield. And ultimately, I think that was the right move, holding him at first.
The batter will be the shortstop, Willie Adames. He's already homered in this game. Check swing, but he went too far. It's 0-1. And a pitch. Oh, this ball is crushed into left field. It's on its way and gone. He'll touch them all. And they add a couple more. It's 6-0.
Times a sinker inside is a foul ball off the ankle for the batter, but that time he did a really nice job of staying inside the pitch and getting through.
The left-hander on now, Daniel Norris. He comes in with his team trailing by a bunch, so he'll try to keep it where it is.
Daniel Norris.
Now it's Christian Yelich.
The left fielder, number 22, Christian.
In there, and it's 0-1.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
Still only one out here in the inning. And he hits a ground ball right side, and foul ball. The 0-2 stays alive. And down on strikes he goes, and there's two away. Now the Brewers cleanup hitter, Andrew McCutchen. He's already homered in this one. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. His second home run of the game, and they add a run. It's 7-0. Singy, he's been red hot.
Yeah, another big swing of the bat for him. Man, he is really seeing the ball well in this one.
Don't you free your mind.
looks like this guy was looking out over the plate, but he was ready to turn on the inside fastball. So direct to the pitch, absolutely blasted out of this ballpark.
Two outs, nobody on. Here's Rowdy Tellez. Grounded out his first time.
The first baseman, Rowdy.
That one fouled off. And the pitch. Check swing, but he went too far. No balls, two strikes. Got it. Out number three. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. It's now 7-0. Top half of the third inning. Here's Jason Hayward.
Leading off for the Cubs.
Well, every pitcher wants run support, and having a lead is nice, but it can be challenging for some guys. I think keeping the mindset to attack instead of trying to be too fine and have too much finesse, go after hitters and get quick outs.
Oh, and two as he waves at that one.
You know, Booth, every team has a hitters meeting pregame, but this lineup seems way too anxious, aggressive. You wonder what they talked about.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. One up, one down.
Well, Boog, I'll tell you, when he goes to look at the video of that pitch, he's going to want to punch himself. That slider had hit me written all over it, and clearly he just got a little too excited and was out in front. Tell you what, when you get a pitch like that, you cannot miss it. Those have a chance to go a long way.
Now it's Andrelton Simmons. And the first pitch misses for ball one. That one missed. Next pitch misses, and that's ball three.
Curveball kind of backed up on him there. I think it just slid out of the hand a little bit too soon.
Next pitch in for a strike, 3-1.
Got some cut action to it. Velocity pretty good on that slider. So far, moving the ball around nicely.
Next offering is fouled back. Payoff pitch, the punch out there, and there's two down. Back-to-back strikeouts to start the frame, and that's now 3 in a row.
Yeah, he's really settling in and getting a feel for his pitches, throwing them where he wants to right now. So we'll see how long he can keep this streak going.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's Nick Madrigal. That one's in there, 0-1. Top of the zone for a called strike.
0-2 count, both pitches on the inside part of the plate. Hitter is thinking, I don't want to get beat here. This is a good time for something off speed away.
And the righty deals. Got him looking. And that is that.
Impeccable command in that one. Three batters, three strikeouts. That's electric stuff out there on the mound. When I come out, they run out. I'll be rocking that stage to the sun out.
Your boy Coop done blown up. Time to lace my boots and show up. And set for the bottom of the third. Now it's Hunter Renfro.
Leading off for the Brewers, the right fielder, Hunter Renfro.
Norris back to work. Swing and he breaks his bat. Fires over to Schwindel, and Renfro is retired.
Well, as a hitter, it can be kind of tough. You get a hard-throwing reliever that comes in the ball game. You don't know exactly what his pitches are doing, and that clearly blew him up on the hand, sawed off that bat. Tell you what, the bat companies, they're pretty happy when guys like this come in out of the bullpen.
Here's the catcher to hit, Omar Narvaez. One for one with a single so far. Started to go after it. Now a look down to third, and yes, he offered at it. Pitch. Check swing, no appeal. Check swing, but he went too far. And it's one and two. Left-hand hitter waits. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And there's two away.
Definitely made him chase a little bit out of the zone right there. I don't think that's a strike if he takes it. Pretty textbook pitching. Get ahead in the count, get the guy in the box on his heels, and then force him to chase your pitch where he doesn't have much of a chance to do any damage.
Here's the center fielder, Lorenzo Cain. His first at bat was a strikeout. Swings through that one, 0-1. And there's a rocket into the outfield. And that extends the inning. Mancini, he hit that ball right on the sweet spot. According to StatCast, the exit velo 110 miles an hour.
Yeah, Boog. I mean, that right there is an absolute missile. And he just put a great swing on it, squared it up perfectly. Those are the ones that feel really good.
Now it's Jace Peterson. Check swing, went around. 1-1. And now the lefty, check swing, but he went too far. And the count is 0-2. Kicks and fires. Hard ground ball, base knock. Oh, he throws it away. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Now batting.
Just a cookie second down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
So the lineup flips over. Digging in, Colton Wong. Fought off foul. And a pitch. They say it went.
Let's go, Brewers.
And he drops it down the third baseline. Wisdom. And that is the inning. Brewers strand a couple, and they hold a 7-0 lead. Back here at the ballpark, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Rafael Ortega.
Rafael Ortega.
Burns back to work. And he dodges that fastball.
Straighten him up a little bit.
The pitch.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Righty delivers.
Ball that time. Come on.
And that one wrapped foul. Swing and a miss, 3-2 now. Righty to the plate. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Man at first, and here's the first baseman, Frank Schwindel. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one. Swings through that one out in front that time.
Well, you got the hitter already chasing that nasty slider. If you're on the mound, you just want to expand the zone right now. Get a swing and miss and get through this at bat.
Swings and misses. And he's down on strikes for the second time today.
That's a pretty nasty pitch right there. I'd call it a power curveball in the 80s. It's got so much spin on it, and you really don't have a lot of time to sit back and watch what it's going to do before you have to commit. It was a good one for the swinging strikeout. Watch me backspin off the atlas. Past tense,
maneuver through you has been. I'm laughing. Don't hit, ignore you. And up to hit is Wilson Contreras. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Here comes a pitch. Strike two.
Wow. Good luck catching up to that one.
The pitch. Right through there. Got him. Out. Number two.
Well, I think that was just a case of a hitter quitting on a pitch. He was looking fastball and didn't see it out of a hand and just left the bat on his shoulder. That was a changeup right over the plate. Probably not the location he was looking for, but the change of speeds is what fooled him, and he got the out.
Ian Happ up to hit. And that's in there for strike one. Swings through that.
Well, you got to find a way to catch up to that pitch. Perhaps shorten the swing, eliminate the stride. That one came in hot, but right down the middle, you're saying to yourself, how did I miss that pitch? Got to make a quick adjustment.
And a swing and a miss, and that's that. One left for the Cubs. Not going their way. It's 7-0. Bottom of the inning. Up now for Milwaukee, Willy Adames. And here it comes. And a good fastball to start him off at strike one. And a pitch. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit.
Clearly seeing the ball very well in this one. Smash that will do the infield for the knock. When it's hit that hard, it makes it very tough on the infielders to make any sort of play.
So, man aboard. Here's the left fielder, Christian Yelich. Foul ball there. the lefty with the 0-1. And a liner out into right center for a base hit. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Now back.
Here's Andrew McCutchen to hit.
Andrew McCutchen.
And that one fouled off. Adames, the lead runner at second. Yelich out at first with nobody out. That one the other way. And there's a hit. Schwindel, relay to third. The tag out.
Now batting. First base.
Rowdy Tellez digs in now. Line drive. That's a base hit as a run scores. Throw comes in and holds the runner at third. They're at the corners now with still only one away. Tags the runner for one. Double play. That erases the go-ahead run. On to the top of the fifth we go. It's the Brewers 8 and the Cubs nothing. Back here at American Family Field. Ready now for the fifth inning. So up now for Chicago, Patrick Wisdom. That's in there. That's strike one.
Clearly down in this ball game, and you can't look at the deficit and try to get it all back in one swing. It's got to come one at bat at a time, and even shrink it down smaller, pitch to pitch. Make that guy on the mound work to get you out.
And he deals. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. And there's one away.
Such a challenge when a guy's got great velocity. He's throwing a slider over 90 miles per hour. You want to be ready to hit that fastball, but that late break just eats you up every time.
Clint Frazier, the next Cub to hit. Swings through that one, 0-1.
Well, on the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at-bat.
Right-hander kicks, deals. That's through there for a strike.
Goodness, I think he just took the best pitch he's going to see in this at-bat. You don't get many like that in that location. I don't know if you take that pitch against any pitcher out there on the mound.
Next offering is foul back. The Cubbies yet to pick up a hit here. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. Two out.
Well, right now he's in cruise control, autopilot, just dominating these hitters. It doesn't look like it's a fun at bat. And all of a sudden, you become in awe of this guy on the mound. Somebody's got to break this thing up. That's five straight strikeouts. Got to put a ball in play.
And here is Jason Heyward. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one. The pitch. And ball one. And the right-hander deals. And a swing and a miss there.
Looking sharp, just a strike away from five shutout innings.
Next offering is foul back. And a 1-2. And another ball. Kicks and deals. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. swing and a miss, and he struck him out. That's the third out, and the Cubs are down in order, and they're on the short end of an 8-0 score. Back here in Milwaukee, up to Renfro at the plate.
Leading off for the Brewers, the right fielder, Hunter Renfro.
And the pitch. And first offering is fouled off. The pitch. And a foul ball. The pitch. Stays alive. On the ground to the left. Whips it to first on the run. And Renfro is retired.
Now batting, catcher, Omar Narvaez.
Here's the Brewers catcher now, Omar Narvaez, 1-for-2. Swing and a ball popped up. Simmons pulls that one down, 2 down.
The center fielder, number 6.
Lorenzo Cain up now for the Brewers. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond, and this guy is at the top of the list. Up the middle, base hit. Joey gets on base and keeps it going.
Oh, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Jace Peterson up now for the Brewers. Line drive. He's got it. And that is out number 3. Brewers strand one as it remains an 8-0 game. Welcome back. Top of the 6th inning. Now it's Andrelton Simmons.
Leading off for the Cubs, the shortstop, Andrelton Simmons.
The right-hander back to work. And there's a ball. And a pitch. He swings and fouls one off. Here's a 1-1. There's a swing and a miss.
Just an outstanding job of spinning the baseball, moving it around, doing what he does.
Next offering misses, and the count is even, 2-2. Kicks and fires. Ground ball left side, and it goes just foul.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
Down on strikes. And now one away. A big performance on the mound. Lots of strikeouts. That was number 14.
Yeah, clearly trusting his stuff in this one, Boo. Feeling really good about what he's working with. And that really allows a guy to attack hitters. Oh, such an important mindset to have out there on the mound, especially when you're ahead in the count with 2 strikes.
Next to hit, Nick Madrigal. He's got it, and there's 2 away.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
Ortega.
And up next for Chicago, Rafael Ortega.
Let's go.
And he swings and misses at the initial offering. The Cubs still looking for their first hit in this one. Next one misses, and that is ball one. And there's a strike. And down on strikes he goes. Third out. So he's through six. No hit innings now. Top of the order due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Brewers eight and the Cubs nothing. Bottom of the sixth inning. Here's the second baseman, Colton Wong.
Here you go. For the Brewers, the second baseman, Colton Wong.
The pitch. In the air, out towards left center. Pat makes the grab. One pitch and one out.
Up next for Milwaukee, the shortstop, Willie Adames.
Now the number two hitter, Willie Adames. He's got a couple homers already, so can he possibly do it again?
Come on, man, of course he can. Those two he hit were legit, and he looks pretty locked in right now at the dip.
First offering is fouled off. And now the lefty. Foul ball. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Got him. Adames down on strikes. Here's Yelich at the dish. One for three. Schwindel. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Nobody left for Milwaukee as the lead holds at 8-0. We go to the top of the seventh. So up now for Chicago, Frank Schwindel.
The first baseman, number 18.
The right-hander back to work.
You know, he's been so great today. Really just throwing whatever the catcher puts down. I mean, hasn't shaken off the catcher very much at all today.
Next pitch inside, and that's ball two.
Struggled a little bit in this one. A couple of strikeouts earlier, but doing a much better job in this at bat to get ahead and find a good hitter's count at 2-0.
In there, base hit! And the bid for history is gone. Not stopping, he's going for three. Safely into third with a leadoff triple.
The catcher, number 40, Wilson Contreras.
And now, Wilson Contreras. First offering misses the mark. Righty to the plate. Pulls that one foul. Schwindel at third with nobody out. Next pitch is outside.
Well, here's a good opportunity in this inning to get on the scoreboard after that leadoff hit, and hardly order coming up right behind them. This is where they need to get going.
The next pitch misses. Counts full, 3-2. Next offering is fouled back.
Going to have some thinking to do when he leaves the ballpark after this one. That was his third strikeout, and this one looking, obviously, so he's been a little overmatched. He's got to find a way just to be more competitive up there at the plate.
Now the left fielder, Ian Happ. First pitch, and he just misses. Left-hand batter waits. Two balls, no strikes, the count. Runner on at third, one gone. The next offering misses, and that's ball three. And the righty deals. That one catches the corner for a strike.
Down to 3-1.
At the belt and fires. And there's a foul ball. One away with a runner at third. And a pitch. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. Here's a big power threat, Patrick Wisdom.
Patrick. And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
Swings through that one, 0-1. Two outs with a runner at third. Next offering is in for a strike. Righty delivers. Stays alive. Here comes a pitch. Rolled over to third. Safe at first as they can't make the play.
Now batting, designated hitter, Clint Frazier.
Clint Frazier, the next Cub to hit. In there for strike one. And a foul ball. Two outs. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Here's the 0-2. And a swing and a miss. Good job at damage control right there. So a run on one hit, no errors, and a man left. Midway in inning number 7, and it's time to stretch. It's the Brewers 8 and the Cubs 1. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the 7th, Jesse Chavez. Big deficit here, but he's still got a job to do. Leading off, Andrew McCutchen.
Really good piece of hitting last time, going to the opposite field.
For the Brewers, the designated hitter, Andrew McCutchen.
Well struck, right field. That one back there, and that is gone. That one barely got out of here. His third home run of the game, and they tack on to their lead. It's 9-1. Singy, the ball is jumping off his bat.
Yes, it is. Tons of loud contact. Man, it's been impressive. He's putting on quite the show with the dish here in this one, and he's just so locked in with his swing, and he's just not missing right now. Three homer game, man, so special. And I tell you what, it's a lot of fun watching him pull it off as well.
Rowdy Tellez, the next to hit.
Now batting, the first baseman, Rowdy.
And first offering is fouled off. And here comes. Lined, and that's a base hit.
Couple of hits in a row for him here. Got a change up and a pretty good one too. Outside corner, but he just got extended and put the barrel on it. Shody has a lot of plate coverage on that swing right there.
And at first, Next for the Brewers, Hunter Renfroe. He's already homered here in this one. Check swing, but he went too far. 0-1. And a strike in there. Next pitch is inside, and it's 1-2. Right-handed reliever. Grounder might be two. They get one. How about that double play? Two outs, base is empty. Omar Narvaez up now for the Brewers. Fly ball pretty well struck out towards right center, way back there, and off the base of the wall. And nice work to hold it to a single. Got it back in fast.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. Anytime you smoke a ball off the wall, you kind of think about what it could have been, but obviously you have to be happy with that result.
Two outs, runner at first. Next for Milwaukee, Lorenzo Cain. In there, and it's 0-1. The pitch. Swing and a ball lifted in the air, shallow left field. No trouble here, puts it away for the out. And that's the third out. One scores in the inning, coming on this solo home run. And this is now a 9-1 ball game. Some people call it rhythm and soul. We go to the eighth. So up now for Chicago, Jason Heyward.
Leading off for the cut.
And a pitch. Right fielder, Jason. And first offering is fouled off. Right-hander kicks, deals. Fouled off. He was late. Kicks and deals. Swing and a high fly ball, pretty well struck right field, way back there, and that ball is gone. He sends it out of here, and they inch closer. It's 9-2.
Well, Boo, clearly some frustration out there on the mound right now. I mean, that ball was so close to going foul. Would have been a long strike, but instead, batter gets rewarded. Did a nice job of getting to the pitch and hitting it hard enough now to get over the fence.
The shortstop.
Now, here is Andrelton Simmons. Popped up to the left, into foul ground. Peterson racing over to make the catch.
The batter number one, second baseman, Nick Madrigal.
And next for the Cubs, Nick Madrigal. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. Pitch bounce to the right side, steps on first for the out.
Now batting, the center fielder, Rafael Ortega.
So the batting order turns over. Now here is Rafael Ortega. Fouled off to the right. Pitch the other way, and that's just foul. And the pitch on the ground, right side, and it gets by him.
Just one of those seen eye base hits through the infield. He just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you a knock.
And now Frank Schwindel. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Ortega leads off first with two down to the inning. On the ground. Oops, he came home with it. And of course, everybody's going to be safe. Yikes.
Well, Boog, I don't have the numbers to back this up or anything, but I think pitchers who tend to rack up a bunch of strikeouts sometimes end up with more errors behind them in the field just because the defenders aren't as involved in the game. They're not as sharp, and who knows if that played any factor there, but I think there could be something to it.
Now the 0-1. And it's fouled away. Oh, and two now. And fouled off. Two outs, a couple of base runners at first and second. The punch out there. So he's gotten deep into this game. And at least so far, not showing a ton of signs of fatigue. Back here at the ballpark, ready for the bottom of the eighth. Here's the third baseman, Jace Peterson.
The third baseman, Jace Peterson.
The right-hander back to work. Bounce to the left side. Wisdom on to first. One up, one down.
Now back, second baseman.
You gotta be kidding me. Did you see that throw?
Not really, Boog. I mean, it happened in the blink of an eye, it seemed, but thankfully StatCast is here to help us out. You don't see many throws across the infield that get up into the 90s, so he really reached back for that one, and he had to get the out.
Drops into the glove, two away.
Now batting, the shortstop.
Up now for Milwaukee, Willy Adames. Gets under and pops it up. Makes the catch, inning over. Three up, three down for Milwaukee. New inning getting started. So now it's the Cubs hitter in the four hole, Ian Happ.
The left fielder, Ian Happ.
And he deals. That one misses. And that's ball one. The pitch. Swings and misses. And it's one and one. Righty to the plate. And a foul ball. Stays alive. Hammered down the right side, but foul. At the belt and fires. Switch through that one. It's a strikeout. Now one gone in the ninth. And up next for Chicago, Patrick Wisdom.
Patrick Wisdom.
And that's in there for strike one. And a pitch. Strike two. Kicks and fires. And now just two outs away.
Excellent arm action on that two-strike changeup. Just missed. Man, we wanted that ball.
Swing and a miss, and he got him. Two down. stepping in, Clint Frazier. And first offering is fouled off. And the righty deals. And a big swing and a miss. And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
It seemed like from the first pitch of this ball game, this guy was going to get it done. Following start, who knew he'd throw a complete game and get the victory. But an excellent job of continuing to just throw what the catcher put down. He navigated through this ball game, a jam here, a jam there, but ultimately it was an outstanding outing.
This one ends the final 9-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shombe. We'll see you soon.
This afternoon for the victorious Brewers, 9 runs on 18 hits, 1 error, they left 7 men on base.